So right here we have popcorn. This is peach cobbler, and this is banana pudding. So Dad is gonna try them today.
We got them from a friend last night. She makes gourmet popcorn.
They smell pretty good.
And we had never heard of these flavors before. So,
like, you can see the, what do you call these?
Like the crisp.
Mm-hmm. This is a banana. What's that one?
Banana. No, this is banana. This is peach right here.
You gotta dry
here.
Your hands off first. I really want him to take these first. And you probably need to drink some water afterwards.
They're sweet.
To cleanse your palate.
Hey, good.
What does it remind you of?
I got one. Banana Laffy Taffy.
Yeah. Like a Laffy Taffy, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And a little chunk of peach. I feel like you need to wash that down. You know, you do a wine tasting.
And what's this? Banana pudding?
Peach cobbler.
Peach cobbler.
If that one tastes like a banana Laffy Taffy, then.
I like that one better.
Oh, I like the banana
better. It's buttery.
What?
My palate must be off.
You ain't taste that butter?
I did at first,
no.
But aftertaste, you don't taste the peach. Mm-hmm.
So, y'all would
try I rate this
flavors?
One
yeah.
A 7 out of 10.
Okay.
And I rate this an 8. Okay, do you want to try them?
What?
The popcorn.
He want goldfish, and I told him no.
Mmm.
Baby, you're cooking Sunday dinner.
Yeah, Sunday dinner.
Breakfast was so good.
We just don't show y'all nothing on the vlog.
Got collard greens, got some fried peas, I'm gonna make some turkey, burger patties.
And some gravy.
And gravy. And this, cornbread. My wife gonna do cornbread.
This morning we made like this quiche omelet with some grits.
Super good.
I made the grits. They were so good.
Yes, Chef Cam. All right, I'm gonna head out.
Hey y'all, and welcome back to another weekly vlog. So I didn't speak to y'all. Yesterday was Sunday. Didn't really do much. Went to church. Came home. I think I showed y'all us taste testing some popcorn. Well, not me, because I didn't put myself on camera taste testing it. But Babe and Cam. So now it's Monday morning. It is 8:36. And Babe and I are on the way to get oil changes for two of the cars. So not really gonna. I mean, I'm bringing y'all with us, but not really too much to show. It's an oil change, right? But definitely it is overdue in this car and then one of the other cars. So we're gonna go handle that business. But yeah, starting this weekly vlog off a little bit different, actually, on a Sunday. Normally I started on a Wednesday. But y'all, honestly, there wasn't really too much going on. It's crazy. I was telling Cameron, right? I said, yeah, I need to pick up the camera and start vlogging. Look at him. And Cam was like, why? There's nothing going on. And I said, you're right. That's why I haven't been vlogging. But trying to push through that because our life contains some type of content that we could share. I'm trying not to. Because here's the thing, right? Ooh, it got dark. Here's the thing. Your daily life consists of some of the same responsibilities and things that you have to do, routines, and all of that, right? But there could be different ways or creative ways that people show it or choose to display it, even though they're doing the same thing every single day. So, let me pay attention because he done already pulled off. Make sure I don't hit him because I would hit him. That's crazy, right? Have any of y'all ever hit somebody that you know, immediate family or not? That's crazy, right? But anyway, yeah, so that's where my head is at. Again, we have stuff going on in our life. It's just I choose not to show some of the things that I've already shown until I can figure out another creative way to do it. Oh, people did have their trash cans out. Good for y'all. Y'all, the Herbie Kirby's, I don't know if you can see that. You saw that. The Herbie Kirby's were picked up today, and we didn't think it would be picked up today because it's Labor Day, but they picked up.
Change.
My oil change was $70. Just buying the stuff.
You feel accomplished, babe? I'm proud of you. It's the first time doing it on the Chevy. No? You did the Monte Carlo?
Yeah, I did. Nah, I didn't do Monte Carlo.
Hey.
Did the Ford, the Honda.
Chevy! Be careful.
Person at extension 1001 is not available. Record your
message. Let me tell y'all something. I cannot stand Prestige uniforms in Greenbrier Mall in Atlanta, Georgia. Can't stand them. The customer service there is horrific. Horrific. All I want to know is if y'all are open, as I understand today is a holiday. I just want to come get my child a blazer for her chapel uniform. Cam, we might have to ride to Sandy Springs. We're going to try one more time. One more time. Hate it.
Due to staff shortage, we will contact you when your order is available for pickup.
I don't have an order.
Press 1 to speak with a sales representative.
Pressing 1.
Press 2 for store hours and...
Like, no message that says that they're closed today. That would be helpful. And Cam walks off. Okay, so the other place that we could try is like an hour away, but I'll see. Because she needs her blazer. See, now they say closed. Labor Day hours, closed. They're in Sandy Springs. Like, they say closed, but I'm still gonna call.
And O'Hara Uniforms in Atlanta, Georgia. Our store is now closed.
See, you see how they tell you they closed? Wait a minute. You see how they tell you that they are closed? Love it. Love it. Love it. These people say they open. So while Google says Labor Day might affect these hours, I'm still gonna go try it.
Dollar bills, y'all, dollar bills.
I'm still going to go try it. And here's the thing, though. What I gotta tell myself is I cannot get upset if they are indeed closed, right? Because it says on Google, Labor Day may affect store hours. So it's all on me. I get that I'm going up there even on a holiday. But I'm still going. And I'm still gonna want to turn up if they try to try me. Hello?
Hi, you called?
Yes, I was just calling to check on you.
Oh, this little, thank you for checking on me.
Are you sure? Because I know your man out of town. Have you eaten?
I know, right? I know, right?
Have you eaten?
Yeah, he sent some money. I still had some rice left over from before he left.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because we not cooking out. We ain't doing none of that. But I was like, we could figure something out. Because it's you. It's you. And we know.
Yeah.
We know.
Yes, no, I'm okay.
Listen, you know that.
My dad actually called him. My dad called him because I guess my dad knew he was out of town, too.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Okay. And he got y'all right.
Yeah, well, he told him to come down to the house. He's supposed to be cooking, so I'm taking the kids so they can get in the pool and I can take a nap. Another nap.
Okay, so y'all finna leave now?
Yeah, Michelle is on the way to pick up her friend boy.
Huh? Her what? Wait a minute. What? Hold on. Look at, no, I hear that, and I ain't worried about that. Cameron right here. So
she driving? Checking on you too.
She driving?
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, I'm letting her drive, but we gotta get her
learning permit. But no, okay. You're in the car with her.
Yeah, I'm
in
the car with her.
Okay.
We just need to get her
money
for me.
Yeah, well, go on and do that. I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
And just chill. If he wanted y'all to come, that's hopefully he got everything taken care of and you gonna be good. Okay, well, when so, I see you,
we'll see y'all later.
Yeah, then I could talk to you.
The lane is between the yellow and the white. You can't just ride on that.
Okay.
Yellow, okay.
Okay. Well, all right. You concentrate. Talk to you later.
Mm-hmm. But you can't be in the other people's lane, though.
Okay? No. Mm-mm. Okay.
Let me show you guys. Okay. Let me.
All
right.
Cam, you think Michelle was driving like that? Yeah, I'm over here dipping off her plate.
Cause it's good. I know how to refresh.
No, how to refresh every time. I should go get some butter. When the car is ready. Oh my God, I didn't tell y'all. Okay, my bad. So. When I first originally came and talked to y'all, it's still Monday. I said we were about to go and get the cars and oil change. So we did do that. I did not lie to y'all. So there's that. But, so we had two separate appointments, but at the same time. So we get there and they was trying to charge like $120 for the Tahoe. The big body Chevy, the heavy Chevy. And babe was like, no, I'm not doing it because I know my capabilities and I know my worth as a side mechanic. I'm just playing. So he was like, no, I ain't going for it. So because he had learned how to change the oil
from Mr. Jeff
on our previous big body, he was like, I got this. So our previous was a Ford Expedition. It was the extra long. And he learned how to change brakes on there and change the oil. So he was like, wait a minute, I can just go over here whoop de whoop to O'Reilly's, get what I need, and change the oil at Mr. Jeff's house. Mr. Jeff is out of town handling his business, right? As breadwinner gang. And so he told Harvey though that he could still go over there and use the tool. He was like, nah, you can't use another man's tool when he not at the house. So car. We came home. We left the other car at the place to get the oil change, because that was only like $55. So that was like, okay, that's fine. We can get with it. So we left that at 9 something. Y'all, mind you, it is 1:04. And they still ain't called to say the car is ready. So that's that. So come home, he start thinking. Like, I know when my husband start thinking, right? Start in this house, because of how my dad was, everything that we needed or everything that Harvey could imagine that he would need is in that garage downstairs. Harvey was concerned about not having a jack, several jacks, because he was concerned, and let me say this, because the jack that he originally located wasn't working. So he thought that was a lost cause, and so that's why he was gonna go down the street to our friend's house and use his jack and all that kind of stuff. But my babe figured it out, as y'all have seen in the previous clips. He figured it out, did the do. Like, that was so damn sexy. Babe, when you watch this vlog, that was so damn sexy. that was so sexy. Like, he figured it out. He nigga rigged shit, but carefully nigga rigged it to do what he needed to do, because he knows the concept. Like, he knows how to change oil, no matter what the vehicle, the make and the model is. He knows how to change oil. She wanna say something. Like, I'm so proud of him, Cam, because he was like, what I'm not finna do is pay over $100. Like, he's sleep mad.
Don't go manly.
That was. Like, the fact that he figured out where he got. Oh my God, he down there turned up, y'all, with his music. Like, the fact that he figured it out is so sexy to me. Sexy! I'm right, fine, good. Y'all, I'm gonna go back to working on my new concept. That is good. Let me just have one more can.
Go ahead, try it in the syrup.
I don't do that.
No, it's so good. It's like a sweet and savory.
All right, y'all, so that's the update. Hopefully they call us soon to let us know that the other car is ready. Cause I think it's crazy. Like, I think y'all heard the conversation. We always do the most on a school night when we should not be. Y'all remember that other vlog where I was like, Sunday is meant for reset. We got to get ready for the week. I don't be taking my own advice, because if they want to put something on the grill, we go. Y'all heard he say, ah. I came to say hey to my son. I seen him, but y'all ain't seen him, because he in his Fortnite mode. In Fortnite vibe. Is this Fortnite, son?
Uh-huh, it is Fortnite.
It's Fortnite.
It's a cool game, but
listen, you know you can't get too turned up, because it's technically about to be a school night. So we gotta prep for that. Right?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
All your homework done?
Yes, ma'am.
We did your video. Was that all we need? I'ma look at the homework grid, because now that you in fourth grade, you legit got homework on Fridays. How you feel about that?
Mad.
It's okay.
Well, Mom, guess what?
Oh, yeah.
I already did my language and math.
Okay, what? Did I check it? I checked it, yeah, because that's when Chloe was over here. Mm-hmm. Okay, y'all. Let me leave him alone.
No!
Cam is about to come down and put her stuff in the washing machine. I think, I don't know, I asked her to, and she's really good about being obedient, and just, I have to be like, okay, the prompt is, this is what we need to do, because this is what we got going on in a couple of hours. So once I prompt, then they're really good, like my kids are really good about handling their business that way, so I'm very appreciative of that.
Thank you, Mom.
You're welcome, son. I knew you were coming. And I just told the people how good you are about just managing that and doing all of that.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Oh my
When you gonna be here?
I say,
first of all, we dropped out of cars at 8:40. And what time it is? 2 o'clock? And y'all closing it soon?
Yeah.
They closing soon?
Yeah, what they say? About an hour. I say, man, y'all funny, man.
But I need to take these off because they're dead. This right here, the brown piece. They're dead. All I have to do is water this piece. This one's dead. But
which
these
plant
look
is
good. This is grandma's plant. I think it's me. So I think it's supposed to be me.
It's Cam.
Yeah.
That's for grandma. Mm-hmm. She named the
plant.
Look
at this one. We need to add more soil. We already added new soil to that one, but we need to add more soil to this one because... Yeah, it just needs some new soil, but look what we did. Put it on the mirror.
Yeah, y'all might have seen that in a previous vlog, how they draped it over the mirror.
And then over the curtains. But I need to do something with this because this just looks sloppy right here. We had draped it over the stairwell, but Dad was like, Mom probably wouldn't like that.
And Mom didn't like it, you're right. You look so beautiful in the sunlight. Skin glowing.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I think this only has like, because we're learning about plants and science, I think these only have one cotyledon on one side right here. I don't know. But I'm not too worried about school right now.
You better teach the people though. Bam, bam. Y'all, I am experiencing pure joy right now. Pure joy, not pure. Pure joy. I just got back to my phone. I'm trying to be quiet because babe is Joe downstairs recording. But I get a text from my friend Jen at 2:21, y'all. Look, it's 2:27. She texts me, smack. That was my high school nickname, y'all. Y'all don't need nothing about that. I need to stop and see you at some point. I said, you in town? ? It's whatever. She said, yes, ma'am. I got a job at the VA, so I am permanently back. I would love to connect. Oh, my God. What a friend. Hold on. Let me pull y'all up, because let me put the praise up emojis. I'm gonna say, I'm at the house. Look, cause everybody know what the house is. I'm at the house. You know. Stop by any time. Oh my God. I want to go tell babe so bad, y'all, but I don't want to go interrupt what he got going on. She said, I got a job at the VA, so I am back permanently. Y'all, if I hadn't put them pictures up, I would show y'all the graduation, the college graduation pic of me and my girl Jen. Yes, my girl. Like this,
she
my girl.
Back in town permanently.
She back in town permanently.
Where did she live?
She probably, before she left, because she lived in VA. I mean, in Pennsylvania, my bad. But before she moved to Pennsylvania for her career, because she's a doctor. She's a doctor of physical therapy. We was vibing on the same street. And there was a time, like.
She like, lived down there.
Yes, literally, like, she. I wasn't here when she was living there. Again, this is my dad's house. This is where I grew up. And so her aunt and uncle took her in for a period in her life. And they lived literally three houses down the street. But I met Jen before I even knew all of that because we went to high school. We went to Mays together. Ironic that I got on that shirt right now. Mm-hmm. But yeah, she, her aunt and her uncle lived three houses down from where I grew up. And so while I was growing up, I didn't know her like that. It wasn't until, I want to say college or maybe senior year, we vibed and we figured that out. So once we knew that, like, I was literally.
Oh, so you didn't even know she was living.
No, because, well, she didn't live down there, Cam. That's what I'm saying. Like, she would come and visit her aunt and her uncle, but it wasn't until they kind of was like, mm-hmm. I don't want to say her guardian or whatever, but it wasn't until we knew all of that that it was like, wait a minute, you down here? This is where I'm at. Like, literally. Three houses down. So the fact that she's back in Atlanta.
You think she gonna move back here?
No, cause her mom is still here. Her mom used to stay in Smyrna, like right down the street from Brooklyn. Aww. You know them apartments right when we get on the interstate?
Yeah.
That's where Mom Dukes used to stay. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Like, what the mess? She said, okay, we'll do. Once I get set up this week, I'll call you to see if you're home. Are you typically home on Sundays? Going to pick up some Saturday. Say yes. After church.
protecting my love. Don't waste this roll call as you hear a voice. Show up, show up,
show up, show up.
Throw up, throw up.
Uh-huh.
You Mr. Nasty.
I clean it up.
Go where nobody's been.
Go where nobody's been.
Have you ever had fun like this?
Have you ever had fun?
I wanna go missing.
I need a prescription.
I wanna
go higher.
Can I sit on top of you?
Okay, I'm slightly annoyed with myself because as someone that knows better, and I'm not a baker by any means, but I should have melted that damn butter. I should have melted that damn butter. That's what I should have did. I should have melted the damn butter because it is not blending the way that I need it to blend. I'm annoyed. I'm annoyed with myself. So what I'm about to do is literally pick the butter up out of this little mix that's not mixing, melt it, put it back over in the bowl, and continue blending. Because I'm annoyed. I'm mad. I just throw the whole no bake away. Should have said no bake but microwave. That's what they should have told the people. Annoyed again, because that ain't even the right mixer. So had I had the right little whatever it's called, maybe I wouldn't have had to melt the butter. What? That wasn't the right whisk. That's what it's called. That's the whisk for the real mixer. Not this baby one that I be playing with, that I pull out when I ain't trying to do too much. Like, y'all, this no bake is really starting to annoy me. This is the one. Yes. So here's the thing, y'all are cricket, there's that. So let's adjust y'all on that. I read the instructions wrong. So not only was I using the wrong whisk on my mixer, I was not comprehending the instructions. Feeling really slow on this simple no-bake recipe. So when I showed y'all blending the butter and melting the butter and all of that, that was supposed to be how I made my crust. So now, this is everything. And don't get me wrong, it tastes amazing, but I have no crust. So me and Cam, we need to actually run out and we need to go to the local uniform store and see if they have a blazer. One, y'all saw me trying to call them earlier. One, see if they're open. Two, if they are indeed open, see if they have a blazer in her size that we can purchase. And while we are out, I am going to get a bag of Chips Ahoy and I guess a bag of Oreos and see if I could recreate this whole crust thing that I effed up. So I'm gonna put this in the refrigerator so it could chill, clean up my mess over here because I'm over it, and then me and Cam are gonna head out and I'll come back to this when my mind is a little bit more clear, because I'm just like, it's very much giving when I fucked up that hamburger helper when I was a teenager. Something as simple as cooking hamburger helper, y'all, messed it up. Not following the instructions. I'm just saying, and it was at this house. It was on this stove that I did that, y'all. Didn't brown the ground beef first. Took the raw ground beef. Took the hamburger helper mix. Yeah, hello son, we see you. Mixed it all up and thought I was supposed to cook it that way. Instead of browning the ground beef first, son, my mama walked in this kitchen. Gigi walked in this kitchen and she said, Rebecca, what is that? Throw it away. So that's very much what this is giving me. And I know how to cook now. So I need to walk away, y'all. Moral of the story is, sometimes you gotta walk away. Yeah. We at damn Greenbrier. Excuse my language. And I'm just like, I feel like they're closed. It's looking real dark. It looked dark. What did the blue sign say, Cam?
Will be closed Monday, September 4th, 2023.
Okay, so they open at 11. So I'm gonna have to come over here. I'll come tomorrow. Cause they close. And then the other spot in Sandy Springs, they closed too. I should have came over here yesterday, but I just didn't. Well, that was quick. So now we finna go find the cookies. You okay? You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Your stomach hurt? I'm sorry. My stomach hurt, y'all. All right, so we finna find these cookies. And I guess we're going back to the house.
Yeah, go. like this. I'm sorry, Miss Jackson.
Hey y'all, so we just got back from Family Dollar, right? I got these viral dumplings. I didn't get the chicken and vegetable, but I got the pork and vegetable, right? So I just gotta get the ingredients. The chili oil, I think, red pepper flakes.
What?
The oil.
I thought the dumplings was the thing.
No.
Oh,
the viral dumplings. So yeah,
what do you need?
The chili oil, but it's at Trader Joe's. So.
Oh, Trader Joe's. You're a bougie still. Oh, I should go this way. I'm not going that way.
Yeah, we're driving off now.
Damn, Family Dollar. Chili oil.
I don't know. I gotta show you a video.
No,
of
don't show me no video. I know the TikTok dumplings, but I think the folk that I've seen. They ain't doing
Mom, what have you been watching?
All right, hey y'all. So we just got back to our house. I'm finna unload these groceries. We got Chips Ahoy, spaghetti Stouffer's for lunch. This is all for lunch right here. And I just wanted to try those little viral Bosco sticks. I got another one. I don't know where it's at though. Got these potato sticks. I don't know about those. We have Kool-Aid Burst, blue flavor, berry blue. What else? I think I'm gonna put these down here so I have more room. Show you. One bag down. Second bag. Some fruit roll-ups, mini rolls. Cookies, because remember we had to get the crust, the cookies in general. Y'all already know. The dumplings. I got two because I already know they're going to be delicious. I also got these dumplings. Family Dollar coming through. Second bag down. Third bag. Goldfish. Oh, Lord, heavy now. Capri Sun Pacific Cooler. The puff corn Chesters. And then here's the other Bosco stick, mozzarella cheese. So I kind of just cleaned out our freezer a little bit. Not really though. I don't know what I'm saying, but I feel like I should put those Bosco sticks with the pizza rolls because I think they just go together. So I'm gonna put those right there. I also think that I should put these dumplings down here too because this is literally all my stuff. And we can't forget these. These are literally in a different shape. If I like them really, like, you know. The Stouffer's is gonna go on the third shelf. The third shelf right there with the Mary, I don't know what that says, Mary calendars. That's all, it's not all the frozen stuff right here. We got all this right here. So I need to figure out where I'm gonna put all of this. Crinkle fries. Feel like I should put this on the second shelf. And I don't even know what I'm about to say.
down, good Lord. Baby got them open all over town. Strictly bitch, you don't play around. Cover much grounds, got game by the pound. Getting paid is a forte, each and every day, true play away. I can't get her out of my mind. I think about the girl all the time. East side to the west side, pushing fat rise, it's no surprise. Got tricks in the stash, stacking up the cash, fast when it comes to the gas. By no means average, it's on when she's got to have it. Baby, you're a perfect 10, I wanna get in, can I get down so I can win? I like the way you work.
Feelings is a no. Let me tell you how it goes. Curves the word, spins the verb. Lovers it curves so freak what you heard. Rolling with the fatness, you don't even know what the half is. You got to pay to play, just for shorty bang bang to look your way. I like the way you work it, trump tight all day every day. You're blowing my mind.
Hey y'all, and welcome to another day in the weekly vlog. So it's just me right now. I came back to the mall to hopefully find the blazer for Cameron. I called the uniform store yet again. They did not answer, but that's okay. They should be open. So I'm hoping they have the blazer. If they don't have the blazer here, then I might head out to Sandy Springs. I really don't want to, but it's 12:40, so this would be the time to do it, because then I should be back on my side of town to pick up the kids like right on time. That would be so perfect. So we are about to do or go in here. It's Tuesday, I don't think I said that, and my battery is about to die, so this is like the perfect timing to just close out this check-in. But wanted to let y'all know what I had going on right now. Come and speak and say hey y'all, hey. And yeah, let's go get this blazer. We're gonna speak positive thoughts, positive vibes. And if they have it, they will have her size. 6 cents, y'all. They had the blazer. So there was a caveat. This is a men's blazer, but I tried it on. And I could get it on. It's still tight on me. So I know Cam will be able to wear it. And I think the only difference is just where the buttons are placed. But yeah, got her blazer. So mission accomplished on my side of town, which I'm really, really happy about. So now I'm about to head to the house. I was going to stop and get me something to eat, but I think I'm good. So I think I'm just going to go back to the house. Put this on Cam's bed. I'm excited. I wish she was home to try it on, but she'll be home soon enough. So yeah, thank y'all. Thank y'all for sending those positive vibes. It worked. Hey y'all, and welcome back to another day of this weekly vlog. I think I'm actually gonna end the vlog today, but before I do, I wanted to come and check in. I did not pick up the camera at all yesterday, which was Wednesday. Not much going on. I did go to Bible study, but I was just really having a bad day yesterday, y'all. I slept, in all honesty, most of the day. I have these spells where I just, you know, I know I'm still in a grieving process. You know, it's been, what, 5 months now, and some days I just don't. But I keep myself motivated. One of the ways is by going to Bible study, and even though I'm going because of my commitment that I've made, the way that I get spiritually fed is unmatched. It's like every single time, whether it's a Sunday or a Monday, it's the word that I need in that moment. And that's kind of what I'm struggling with too, right? In churches, in a church setting, or even if you're watching on live. But to me, watching online and being in the building is not the same, but that's a whole nother topic, right? But in the moment, you feel so energized. You feel so refreshed. You feel so motivated. And then for me, at least, it's like as soon as I walk out of the building and I start thinking about life and things and day to day, it's kind of like a crash and burn moment almost. So one of the things that I do plan to do today is go back and listen to that sermon, because although I no longer have my earthly father, I still have my heavenly father, my spiritual father, and he has everything that I need. I can talk to him, he can talk back to me, he can protect me, he can provide for me in the same manner that an earthly father would, right? And at the end of the day, I can do no wrong in his eyes. Even when I get upset, even when I get mad, even when I don't do what I'm supposed to do, as it relates to him and the way that I treat him, right? He still loves me. His love is unconditional. Whereas earthly relationships don't always shake out like that. And I'm not just thinking about it from like my dad's perspective. Just any relationship in general, right? It's most of the time it's based on conditions. You do this for me. You make me feel a certain way. Oh, I love you to the moon and back. The moment you do something that I don't like or that I disagree with, then now we got a problem. But it's not like that with God. But the balance is I'm still human, right? I still have feelings and I'm missing that void. So anyway, that's kind of what was going on with me yesterday. But I am glad that I went to Bible study. So that's that on that. I think the last time that y'all saw me out and about, right, I was picking up Cam's blazer. Didn't fit, so I need to take that back today. I want to take that back today. What else? I need to fold some clothes that are back here on the bed. I need to wash some clothes that are down here. I need to pack because we're going on a little overnight trip. Cameron, her best friend, and myself. We're actually going to support our first lady and another lady in ministry at a women's conference they're participating in. So we head out tomorrow, which is Friday. But before we head out and hit the road, I'm volunteering at the school because it's morning with grandparents. I think Grandparents' Day is Saturday or Sunday. So they're having a little something for the grandparents. So I'm helping out with that, and then we're gonna hit the road. I also need to get Caden an overnight bag because he's gonna stay with Gigi because Harvey will be on the road for work. So that's a lot, but it's not really a lot. It's only 10:14 right now, so I feel like if I get it in gear, I can do most of the stuff that I need to do related to packing and figuring out what I want to wear before I need to go pick up the kids. I might have to help with pickup. Still waiting to hear if they're gonna need my help for that this afternoon.
I guess that's why you like it, baby. Come and give it. Takes a lot to excite me, baby. Give it a try. I'm a good cookie, baby. Get the right stuff. You texting me, you know I won't reply. Why you wait with me when I wasn't this fly? Now I'm on top and now I'm riding sky high. Don't need nobody, but I'll take you down tonight. And now I'm okay with being nasty. So you can hop for all these clothes anywhere. My body dripping, boy, but you gon' have to wait. But when you get it, lick it like a candy cane. Your eyes on me apply.
I done made myself hot, y'all. And I'm pretty sure it's because I'm wearing this, but I'm keeping it on. So we've made progress, y'all. We've made progress. I have picked out some outfits for the conference itself. So I need to be, or I need to have on my outfit tomorrow on the way down there, which I don't really, I'm not happy about having to like drive almost 4.5 hours dressed up or whatever, but I have no choice. So I need an outfit for tomorrow, which is Friday, and then I also need an outfit for Saturday morning. So let me show y'all what I came up with. Oh, and I did check the weather. It's gonna be slightly hotter than it is in Atlanta. So we're talking about highs basically in the mid 90s. So while I'm not happy with my body right now, because I have truly gained weight, I'm not as big as I was, but if I keep acting like if I keep doing what I'm doing, I'ma easily be back where I was. But I feel like I've gained at least 40 pounds back from when I had my success in my weight loss journey. So things that were effortless for me during that time, like dresses that I have, that was just a whole mood and a whole vibe, they look so tight, stomach good. It's like booty do. If y'all know about booty do, then you understand. So anyway, this is one, and so this one is see-through, has cut out on the side. I would definitely, I mean, I've worn this to church before, but it's sleeveless, zips in the back, and it hits right below the knee. So this is an option, and I need to wash it. So this, and then I have this little sundress. It stretches in the middle, so when I was smaller, you know, this was good, but now I feel like this might be sitting on my stomach. Like even as I pull and I stretch now, it's like sitting on my stomach. But this could be an option. The only thing is, like with that other dress, I wouldn't have to wear a bra because I don't like wearing bras. And quite frankly, I don't need to because my chest is so small. But with this, I feel like it's a little see-through, so I don't know. But I think it's nice. It's Florida. It's giving Florida. Then we have this dress, which is really cute. I love this. I'm just, you know, there's not much stretch, so I don't know what it's gonna do, but I will. And then I have this. This is long sleeve. And then it's also see-through. And then it has like this little, not ruffle detail, but it has kind of like a flare detail at the bottom. And then it comes with the piece underneath because it is see-through. Now it is long sleeve, but I feel like because it's see-through, it'll be okay. So those are the options that I'm giving myself. Nothing more, nothing less. And then for shoes, let me show y'all shoes. So I'm taking these just to have, and I'll put them in the bag that I carry, like my little tote, this tote right here. Show y'all because it's right here. So I have this little tote, so I'll just literally put them in there. So those will be that. And in fact, I'm just going to throw them over there by my tote. And then these would be kind of like the shoes that I would wear. So these could go with three of the dresses, right? So I could wear this with the see-through long sleeve dress. I could wear it with the black and white dress. And then I could wear it with the, it actually, I think that would be too much yellow, with the yellow sundress. So then I might pair it with these. And I like these because they have this acrylic heel. They're not that high. These came, I've had these a while. These actually came from, I want to say JCPenney, and they're patent leather. Very comfortable. Cute, stylish, and comfortable. And then these, I haven't worn these, but these are by Michael Kors, but I feel like these would be comfortable as well. And like I said, I'm packing my little flats. So yeah, that's what I'm working with. I also need to pack like my casual stuff, like if we go out to dinner, and then pack what I would want to change into on the drive back Saturday. I have Caden packed as well. So his pile is on the bed over there. So just his clothes, his pajamas, like his lounge socks. That was real simple. And so the only thing for all of us that I'll need to worry about in the morning actually is just our toiletry bags. So I'm feeling good about the progress. Let me check in on the time. So it is 11:35. I don't know if y'all can see that. 11:35. Y'all can't see that. Whatever. Just take my word for it. It's 11:35. So yeah, I think I'm gonna get some more of my stuff together and then figure out if I wanna wash now or if I wanna wait. Attention. Bye. We made it, y'all. We made it. Whew. I failed. It's hot. Whew. Now I see what my daughter goes through every single day because she does safety patrol every day. I am so proud of her. But anyway, Bishop just asked me to go in the sanctuary and shut stuff down. So that's what I'm about to do before I get off the property. Daughter over there, y'all. I think she liked when her mama at the school. What'd you think? You like when I'm at the school? Yeah? Say it loud. Say it loud for the people in the back. We are in the back. She said we are in the back. We are in the back. He asked me if I was Miss D. And I know why he asked me that now. Because I got on her radio. I'm sure he saw it. I might have muffled y'all. He probably asked me that because I got on her radio. And I was like, no, I'm not. And then I told him my name. I wish he would try you.
Oh, did you talk to Miss Bacala?
Yeah, she said she called somebody else.
All right, so we back at the house. I don't know if I told y'all, but I'm so mad at myself. So I did not go and exchange the blazer, but oh my God, what did that? Y'all see that? It just flew up on the window. What the mess? Bring that, oh my God. I'm sorry y'all, hold on. I got to go up, cause I'm on the tripod. Y'all see that? This sucker just flew. My God. It literally just flew on the window while I was up there, y'all. And now it's gone. Okay. Anyway, let me bring y'all back up. But, my train of thought just gone. Okay. I think I was saying, and I didn't know if I already shared with y'all. I didn't get a chance to return the blazer before I went to their school. So in the midst of all of that activity, some of which y'all saw, I lost the receipt to return the blazer. I'm so mad at myself because the last thing the lady told me when I walked up out of that store on Tuesday, two days ago, was returns with receipts within 30 days. The receipt was in my pocket. I shouldn't have had it in my pocket because I was doing too much. I was moving too much, obviously. So I get in the car. We ready to head to the mall to return the blazer before we come back to the house. I'm checking my pockets. There had to be nobody but the Holy Spirit. Receipt is nowhere to be found. So I'm slick ticked about that. But with everything in life, when something bad happens, you can kind of find a silver lining. So I guess the silver lining would be, I told y'all already, it's a men's blazer. So we can just save it for Caden, and he'll already have his blazer when the time comes. He'll need it in 2 years. 2 years. But in my mind, I'm still like, it's $100 down the drain. Anyway, I am about to get my clothes out of this basket, finish packing, give Cam the stuff that she washed so she could pack, and we just gonna go ahead and end it right here, y'all.
Enemies shine. You cannot depend on me and to the light, cause you can never kill my vibe.